Hello everyone, welcome to the class of the probability and statistics. Today we will see how you can prove the Chebyshev inequality. So that's a very simple proof is there, we can see in this video. Myself Dr. Garg, working in the School of Mathematics Thapar Institute India. You can contact me, either of my email IDs are there if you feel any doubt regarding this probability and statistics, or else you can simply click on this link for finding the more updated videos on the probability and statistics. So what we have seen in the last class related to Chebyshev inequality is that these are the formulas for the Chebyshev inequality and how you can solve such type of the problems we have discussed in our last video. There are the more than 7 to 8 examples we have discussed that. You can simply write this Chebyshev inequality on this YouTube. You can find the related videos there. In this text, in this short 5 to 6 minute video, we have seen how you can prove this Chebyshev inequality. What is the statement for the Chebyshev inequality is, for any random variable x having the mean mu and the finite variance is there. So make sure that the variance must be the finite. Then for any real number k, that is a positive real number, this inequality holds. Then how you can prove that this Chebyshev inequality will work or related to them. So I just give you just brief idea that how you can prove that. Firstly, look at that, this is the deviation x minus mu. So if this is the mu and this is nothing but mu plus k sigma and mu minus k sigma will be there. So what is the meaning of that? X minus mu is mod of x minus mu is greater than k sigma. Which part is there? So if you know the inequality part, so what is that? This is the green portion. So what is the meaning is that the total sum of this green portion will be 1 by k square. So can you find this sum? Because it's a probability mass function. So this is nothing but 1 by k square. So if you know the k is my any real number. So if I say k is my 2, then it will be 1 by 4. K is 3, then 1 by 9 and so on. So I just give you the two proofs. You can remember any one of the proofs. So both are the very simple. First one proof is based on the Markov inequality. What is the Markov inequality? For any random variable z and a is my constant number, this inequality holds, then this inequality is called as the Markov inequality. So based on this, we can prove this Chebyshev inequality within the two lines. How you can prove? You can compare them. Can I take this z as x minus mu whole square because it's a mode quantity? So it's absolute value, so I can take as a this. And this a is my positive quantity, so I call as the k square sigma square. So if you substitute z and a in this, what you get? You will get here. So this, look at that, the left hand side is nothing but here. Okay. And now you have to prove only the right hand side should be 1 by k square. So if you clearly look at that, what is the numerator part? Any formula for this? Yes, this is nothing but my variance. This is nothing but my sigma square. What is the sigma is? If you remember that sigma, if for the discrete distribution, this is x minus x bar or x minus mu. This is my here divided by and so on. So now this is the variance. So if you sigma square will be cancelled out. So the remaining will be here. So that's the proof of this Chebyshev inequality. Other way, this is the second method. You can prove this with the help of the random variable. So since it is not given that the random variable is a discrete or continuous, so we consider both part. First one, I assume that x is my continuous random variable. So if it is continuous random variable, then corresponding to this continuous random variable, f is the PDF. Now I can start with the variance. So since this is the definition of the variance, e is nothing but the expected value. So I can write like this way. Now you can see on the graphical here, this is my mu. This is my, this is mu plus of k sigma, and this is my, say, mu minus k sigma. So if you look about that, minus infinity to plus infinity is a whole line. So I divide this real line into the two portion. One is all those x minus mu which are less than of the k sigma, other is are greater than k sigma. What is that portion? This portion is nothing but this one and this one, while x minus mu less than k sigma means minus k sigma to plus k sigma is there. Now the rest proof is very simple. Now since these are the two quantities. So can I write this as greater than of this quantity always, because this is a positive quantity. So sum of the two number, positive number, will be greater than of this single number. Now you can substitute, how you can write that? This is the part of the x minus mu. So I can substitute the value of here. This is k square sigma square. Look at that. Now left hand side is moving on the sigma square. So what you get? Sigma square will be cancelled out. What is the left is 1. So k square will be in this side. So can I write after this is? Because this is my sigma square. So sigma square will be cancelled out. So this is 1 by k square. So look at that. What is that? How you can write probability of x say greater than 1 for any distribution? How you can write is, this is 1 to infinity f of x dx. So same for here. Look at that. Instead of x greater than 1, it is will be here f of dx. So can I write this portion as of this? Of course, this is nothing but here, and this part is there. So this is the proof of the Chebyshev inequality for the continuous random variable. Now if someone asks you for the discrete random variable, the proof is quite similar. Instead of the PDF is a PMF. What is the difference between the discrete and continuous is, instead of this integration sign, you have to take only for the summation. Look at the proof is exactly similar. Just replace integration to be the summation sign. So look at the sum will be greater than of this. Now you can substitute this value here. It will be my k square sigma square. Left hand side is nothing but my sigma square. Now sigma square will be cancelled out. It will be my 1 by here. Now it's a discrete distribution. This is nothing but my p of this. So this is the quite proof. So that's the quite simple proof. You can use any one of them, either the discrete, continuous, or the Markov inequality. So if you find any other videos related to this probability and statistics, you can simply browse this link or subscribe it for more updated video. Till then, best of luck.